Templar deserters?
You, I'd be dead. Do you need anything? I should probably report back.
It looks like someone was having a picnic.
Yes. The mage must have been hunting for blood magic.
This is a mage.
Eldreda, yes. I think that was her name. At least I'd heard other apostates call her that. The Templars attacked the apostate. I suppose I just got caught in the middle. So, the truth. I may have been, passing time with Eldreda.
I take it the Templars interrupted your very friendly picnic.
Wait. Yes. At first, she was just a mage who saw me and didn't attack, but later we... So, are you going to report me?
Look, kid, if you can talk an apostate out of her pants in the middle of a war, you've got a gift. Use it. Make contacts, get information, and help the Inquisition. Do that, and our lips are sealed.
All right. I can do that. And thanks for going easy on me.
Damn it, Ritz. Where are you?
I found Ritz and rescued her from an attack by the Templars. She's fine.
Thank you. I appreciate you taking the time. It's dangerous out here for everyone. I'm glad the Inquisition is trying to put things right.
Please, hurry.
Here you go. The potion and instructions on how to make it.
Silas, bless you. Or the Maker. Or whoever. It doesn't matter. Just thank you. I'll give it to her right away. If ever I can help the Inquisition, you have my word.
This will help.
It more than helps. With this, I can fill these hungry bellies, give these folks some hope. I didn't think much of the Inquisition, but no one else is helping like you lot. Maybe I was wrong.
You're kind of a force of nature, aren't you?
When I need to be.
It's impressive.
You flatter me.
I'm trying.
Did I do the right thing? What I have set in motion here could destroy everything I have revered my whole life. One day they may write about me as a traitor, a madwoman, a fool. And they may be right.
What does your faith tell you?
I believe you are innocent. I believe more is going on here than we can see. And I believe no one else cares to do anything about it. They will stand in the fire and complain that it is hot. But is this the Maker's will? I can only guess.
You don't think I'm the Herald of Andraste?
I think you were sent to help us. I hope you were. But the Maker's help takes many forms. Sometimes it's difficult to discern who it truly benefits, or how.
What's going to happen now?
Now, we deal with the Chantry's panic over you before they do even more harm. Then we close the breach. We are the only ones who can. After that, we find out who is responsible for this chaos. And we end them. And if there are consequences to be paid for what I have done, I pay them. I only pray the price is not too high.
Isn't it a bit late to worry about it now?
We have only just begun. My trainers always said, Cassandra, you are too brash. You must think before you act. I see what must be done, and I do it. I see no point in running around in circles like a dog chasing its tail. But I misjudged you in the beginning, did I not? I thought the answer was before me, clear as day. I cannot afford to be so careless again.
Can't say I'm not grateful to hear that.
I can be harsh, I know. You've said you believe you're chosen. Does that mean you believe in the Maker?
I believe he exists.
That's comforting. Surely the Maker put us both on this path for a reason. Now it simply remains to see where it leads us.
Something here. Better take a closer look.
Good day to you.
Flissa thought you and your men might be working up a thirst. She sent me over to see if you needed anything.
We're fine, thank you.
Good day to you.
Come on!
kind killed the most holy. Lies. Your kind let her die. Shut your mouth, mate!
Enough!
Knight Captain!
That is not my title. We are not Templars any longer. We are all part of the Inquisition.
And what does that mean exactly?
Back already, Chancellor. Haven't you done enough?
I'm curious, Commander, as to how your Inquisition and its herald will restore order as you've promised.
Of course you are. Back to your duties, all of you. Mages and Templars were already at war. Now they're blaming each other for the Divine's death.
Which is why we require a proper authority to guide them back to order.
Who? You? Random clerics who weren't important enough to be at the Conclave.
The Rebel Inquisition and its so-called Herald of Andraste? I think not.
If the proper authority hadn't completely failed, the Conclave wouldn't have been needed.
So you suggest I blame the Chantry and exalt a murderer? What of justice?
That won't help restore order in the here and now.
Order will never be restored so long as this rebellion is allowed to fester.
How widespread is the violence between mages and Templars?
Impossible to say.
Your organization flouting the Chantry's authority will not help matters.
With the Conclave destroyed, I imagine the war between mages and Templars is renewed with interest.
The mages and Templars are fighting, even though we don't know what really happened at the Temple of Sacred Ashes.
Exactly why all this should be left to a new divine. If you are innocent, the Chantry will establish it as so.
Or we'll be happy to use someone as a scapegoat.
You think nobody cares about the truth? We all grieve Justinia's loss.
But you won't grieve if the Herald of Andraste is conveniently swept under a carpet.
Remind me why you're allowing the Chancellor to stay.
Clearly, your Templar knows where to draw the line.
He's toothless. There's no point turning him into a martyr simply because he runs at the mouth. The Chancellor's a good indicator of what to expect in Val Royeaux, however.
Well, let's hope we find solutions and not a cathedral full of chancellors.
The stuff of nightmares.
Mark, if you will. I'm certain the Maker is less amused.
I will keep the peace while you and the others appeal to the Chantry in Val Royeaux.
Better ready yourself for the blame you will be rightly assigned.
When will you be able to get us the crafting supplies we need?
Farewell.
Make a go with you.
Blessed are the peacekeepers, the champions of the just. Blessed are the righteous, the lights in the shadow. In their blood, the Maker's will is written. Is that what you want from us? Blood? To die so that your will is done? Is death your only blessing?
You speak for Andraste, no? What does the Maker's prophet have to say about all of this? What's his game?
How is this a game?
Do you see the sky? What about the temple ruins? The bones lying in the dust? Even if you didn't support the Divine's peace, you wouldn't call this right. Who could? So many innocent lives. The faithful murdered where the holiest of holies once stood. If the Maker willed this, what is it if not a game or a cruel joke?
I speak for no one but myself, and I have no answers for you.
Then we can only guess at what he wants. The Chantry teaches that the Maker abandoned us. He demands repentance for our sins. He demands it all. Our lives, our deaths. Justinia gave him everything she had, and he let her die.
I'm sorry. Her death has clearly hit you hard.
Not just me. All of us. She was the divine. She led the faithful. She was the heart. If the Maker doesn't intervene to save the best of his servants, what good is he? I used to believe I was chosen, just as some say you are. I thought I was fulfilling his purpose for me, working with the divine, helping people. But now she's dead. It was all for nothing. Serving the Maker meant nothing.
Maybe you have another purpose. I could help you find it.
No, this is my burden. I regret that I even let you see me like this. It was a moment of weakness. It won't happen again. Come, to work then. We will speak later.
Secret asked, told me that he can't let the herbs go for anything less than 8.
Fine. We'll gather our own. Tell Secret, he better hope he doesn't need a salve anytime soon.
Researcher Minave wishes to verify that the infections have decreased in number.
Yes. Thank you for your help. Tell me, are you happy this way, with everything you feel and dream cut away?
I no longer talk to dragons.
I see. Maker, go with you. Greetings, Herald of Andraste. How fares your quest to seal the breach?
I'm doing everything within my power.
A task such as closing the breach is a heavy burden. I hope you do not carry it alone. We remember Andraste, but Andraste did not carry the Chant of Light alone. She had generals, advisors, even her husband for a time. Do everything within your power, but remember those who would help you.
You keep talking as though I'm the equal of Andraste. Do you know how unnerving that is?
I can only imagine. But we are all given to our purpose under the Maker. A sword does not ask to be forged. And frankly, if such a comparison gives you pause, I do not see that as a bad thing. In any case, I pray this Inquisition proves less brutal than its predecessor.
Do you know who the Grand Clerics will choose as the next Divine?
It is a difficult decision. All the obvious candidates perished with Divine Justinia at the Conclave. The Grand Clerics are terrified of the Inquisition. They will not decide soon, and I fear they will not decide wisely. Whoever is chosen needs the Inquisition's support. No one else seems likely to seal the breach.
I don't believe I've had the chance to speak candidly with the revered mother. Can you tell me about the Chantry?
I presume you mean deeper questions about the organization itself. Even in the circle at Ostwick, you should have been taught the basics.
What is your stance on magic?
Andraste put it simply. Magic must serve man, not rule over him. However, those words must be put into the proper historical context. Andraste led a rebellion against the Javinta Imperium, whose magisters controlled most of the world at the time. Even then, she never called for all mages to be put to death. She believed in peaceful coexistence.
I don't recall the Chantry being as tolerant of magic as you describe.
No. The Chantry is an imperfect vessel, pulled in every direction by those who would steer its course. Yet the Templars rebelled precisely because Divine Justinia was not restrictive enough. Perhaps the Inquisition will find a better way.
Why does the Chantry allow only human women to become priestesses?
The official doctrine is that elves and dwarves have turned further from the Maker than humanity. And as for men, the chant holds that they are more vulnerable to anger or passion. But in truth, it is simply political, added after Andraste's death, like too many of our beliefs.
If you don't believe these restrictions are what Andraste wanted, why haven't you tried to change them?
Has the current state of the world not taught you the folly of fighting too many battles at once? I chose to use what power I had to help peasants forgotten by the nobles of Orlais. I believed there would be time to address their inequality under the Chantry once we had saved them from starving.
There were calls for an exalted march to put down the Mage Rebellion. What was your opinion?
It was ignorant gossip. An exalted march only succeeds when it carries the will of the people. Even then, it cannot be undertaken lightly. People are too easily frightened. We cannot destroy everything they fear. An exalted march is justified only against a true threat to this whole world. It is an offense to the Maker to use it as a political bludgeon, or as a means of spreading the chant of light.
What about the exalted march that conquered the elves?
That is a hotly debated matter in some circles of the Chantry. The elves had conquered Mont-Saint-Marthe and threatened Val-Royeaux itself. They were not helpless victims. But even then, Orlais was the only nation to provide troops. It was hardly an exalted march of all the faithful. The Maker wishes his world to spread by example, not by war. We win no converts with
farewell, revered mother.
Make her go with you. I greet you.
How are the people doing after what happened at the Conclave?
They are scared, of course. Many have lost homes or loved ones. I doubt many will sleep well until you have sealed the breach. I have offered what help I can. The rest is for the Inquisition. What more do you wish to know?
How are the villagers in Haven doing?
They are terrified. Many of them came here because the war between the mages and the Templars destroyed their homes. In their minds, the death of a divine has destroyed any chance of peace. To that, add the breach. Farmers have fled their fields. If we do not restore order, half of Thedas may starve.
What are you doing to help these people?
My sisters and I have been tending to the injured as best we are able. Some refugees come with food, while others arrive empty-handed. I have helped ensure that all have enough to eat. Beyond that, many simply wish the familiar comfort of the Chant of Light. It is little enough work to offer some comfort to those in pain.
Do you have information on people elsewhere?
The refugees in the Hinterlands are desperate. Without help, starvation or war will claim many lives. Villagers in Crestwood are besieged by their own dead. They have sent word begging for assistance. People are vanishing in the hills of Emprise de Lyon. It may be demons or something worse, but they are terrified. More than that, I cannot say. It is a chaotic time for all in Olay and for Elden.
Farewell, revered mother.
Farewell. Greetings, Herald of Andraste.
Can you tell me about the original Inquisition?
The original Inquisition was formed after the first Blight, well before the Chantry as we know it. The Inquisitors were hunters, zealots, who tracked and killed cultists and dangerous mages. As Andraste rose to power, the Inquisition came into her service. Instead of hunting those who would do harm, the Inquisitors spread the chant of light by force.
It must be difficult to follow the chant of light, knowing how it spread.
Indeed. I have always believed that the Maker wished us to spread the chant of light by example, not violence. In any case, once the chant of light had spread far and wide, there was less need for zealots. The Inquisitors became the seekers of truth, and eventually the Templars.
This is a dark chapter of history for the Divine to revisit.
Do you know what impresses me most about the original Inquisition? They fought horrific battles, killed and died for their cause, and when it was time, they put their swords away. Perhaps the name was Divine Justinia's message, that when the Inquisition is needed, it will strike without mercy. But when its work is done, it will put its sword away.
Is there anything I can do to help you or your people?
My healers would benefit from more supplies. We have run short of even common goods with so many wounded. If you could deliver this list and the items on it to Quartermaster Thren, she could get us what we need. It may not seem like much, but it would enable my healers to save many lives.
Farewell, revered mother.
Farewell.
The Inquisition cannot remain ambassador if you can't prove it was founded on Justinia's orders.
This is an inopportune time, Marquis. More of the faithful flock here each day. But allow me to introduce you to the brave soul who risked her life to slow the magic of the breach. Sir Trevelyan, may I present the Marquis Durellion, one of Divine Justinia's greatest supporters.
And the rightful owner of Haven. House Durellion lent Justinia these lands for pilgrimage. This Inquisition is not a beneficiary of this arrangement.
This is the first I've heard of Haven having an owner outside the Chantry.
My wife, Lady Matchin of Denerim, has claim to Haven by ancient treaty with the monarchs of Ferelden. We were honored to lend its use to Divine Justinia. She was a woman of supreme merit. I will not let an upstart order remain on her holy grounds.
Demons are pouring from the sky, and you're worried about land claims.
Haven is the Durellion's rightful property.
Has Empress Selene officially acknowledged your possession of Haven? I was unaware Her Imperial Majesty had conferred with Ferelden's monarchs on this matter.
The Empress has not yet had the opportunity to do so.
We face a dark time, Your Grace. Divine Justinia would not want her passing to divide us. She would, in fact, trust us to forge new alliances to the benefit of all, no matter how strange they might seem.
I'll think on it, Lady Montpellier. The Inquisition might stay in the meanwhile.
Do the Durellions actually have a claim on this place?
His Grace's position is not so strong as he presents it. Despite their Ferelden relations, the Durellions are Orlesian. If the Marquis wishes to claim Haven, Empress Selene must negotiate with the Ferelden on his behalf. Her current concerns are a bit larger than minor property disputes.
I apologize for the intrusion. I didn't realize you were meeting with the Marquis.
You did little harm. In truth, the debate was most beneficial as practice for those to come.
You expect more people in Haven?
Undoubtedly. And each visitor will spread the story of the Inquisition after they depart. An ambassador should ensure the tale is as complimentary as possible.
May I ask, what brought you to work for the Inquisition?
Sister Leliana approached me. We've been acquainted for quite some time. For better or worse, being the Inquisition's diplomat has become as interesting as she promised.
What sort of dealings have you had with nobility?
For some years, I was the royally appointed court ambassador from Antiva to Orlais. The nobility of Thedas is a rather singular sphere. Those I'm not acquainted with, I know through reputation.
The Inquisition is lucky to have you as an advocate, Lady Montpellier.
Thank you. Let us hope so. Thedas's politics have become agitated as of late. I hope to guide us down smoother paths. But please excuse me. I've much work to do before the day is done.
Yes. Good.